it.
Holy hellhounds, those dogs sound out for blood.
Rat! Just dust, bunny.
Hello?
Dust, bunny! Just rat.
Holy hellhounds! Those dogs sound out for blood.
Buddy?
Fallback! Sorcerer! Trix! Birdie! Intruder!
Bruno! Buddy! Buddy! My mate!
This can't be it.
Buddy? My buddy! But work! Search! Sorceress? Why? Buddy!
Emmy! No! Sorcerer! Bad! Baddies! Bite! Roof!
But Bruno! I miss my buddy.
You, sorcerer, go! Emmy, crying!
Sorcerer, die! Kill!
Argos
kill.
Is a good dog.
Emmy, sad!
Just Bunny! Just rat! Oh. Buddy! My buddy! Bruno! Buddy, leave!
My tummy hurts.
I don't think...
Emmy, no!
But...
No! Sorcerer, stop!
Hello?
yield to none.
Your maker.
Did you expect a needle?
My tummy hurts. My tummy hurts. My tummy hurts. This can't be it. Tummy hurts. My tummy hurts. Can't be it. be it. This can't be it.
A dog is quietly curled in the corner of the cave. A dog is quietly curled.
Please, don't hurt me! But I might hurt you. You smell like what they feed me. They changed me. They made me want to hurt people.
A low growl. The dog starts to salivate and lick his chops. His eyes go hard and cold. Suddenly, he seems to remember himself and whines.
They did something to me. They made me want to hurt people. People who smell like you. I don't want to hurt anyone! I'm afraid. If I leave, I might hurt someone. If I stay, they'll make me into one of their monsters. I'm better off dead. Hello? My tummy hurts.
And you thought Rivelon was flat. 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 And you thought Rivelon was flat.
Bishop Alexander is looking rather regal.
Artistic license and all.
You aren't tired of my stories, are you? Can you even hear me in there? That, of course, was so many years ago now. I can hardly remember the smell of his skin anymore. Oh, but I've told you about that many times before, haven't I? Silly me.
You are tired of my stories.
The creature absently picks at the stitches that bind its lips. It starts to bleed, but doesn't seem to.
That, of course, was so many years ago now. I can hardly remember the smell of his skin.
You aren't tired of my stories, are you? Can you even hear me in there?
The creature doesn't acknowledge your question. It stares at the ground and shuffles away.
I can hardly remember the smell of his skin anymore.
Oh, but I've told you about that many times before, haven't I? Silly me. You aren't tired of my stories, are you? Can you even hear me in there?
As the Magister turns to face you, you feel Fain stepping up behind you.
Have you seen these contraptions? This must be the Magister freak the blacksmith was referring to. He may have the very tool I need to craft my mask.
Fain cheerfully explains that he needs something to rip off a person's face, even demonstrating the idea by reaching over and tugging on the Magister's cheeks. Rather than reacting with horror, the Magister seems excited, very excited. He explains that he might have just the thing.
Unfortunately, the Magister does not seem willing to part with it, no matter what Fain offers. The undead turns and storms away.
Who are you, you lovely little puppy?
He reaches out and gently touches your bandaged arm.
My, you're not quite who you seem to be, are you? Our little secret. Please, come in. Oh, do make... Tut, tut, I won't hear anything to the contrary, and there's nowhere for you to go, love. Please stay with me in my playground. You're not listening, darling. Perhaps we should start with making a little more space within those ears of yours. Come, come, darlings. Time to die for Papa.
You, I'll flay you alive! I'll flinch the blubber from your bones! I'll yield to none.
Thank you.
focus.
hounds take you.
Damn you! I'll flay you alive! I'll flint the blubber from your bones!
I won't say it again. Lent.
Out!
Greet the Reaper for me.